As we begin to talk about lead scoring, what we want to keep in mind is all of the different ways that you can utilize it. Lead scoring is a feature that's going to really give you the opportunity to track and add point values to a contact based on certain things that they're doing. It's going to give you an opportunity to build scoring systems around different measurements. Let's use engagement for an example. If a contact opens an email, you can build scores around that. If they interact with your content in any way that makes the most sense for you, you can also build scores around that. These will become key identifiers in letting you know how likely somebody is to either engage or convert or make a purchase based on the scoring system that you've created. Different strategies you can utilize are going to be learning at a glance. You really have an opportunity here to look at scores in a very quick way in order to determine and understand who you need to communicate with right away and who you might need to nurture a little bit more. You have the ability to add a column into your contact profile so that you're able to see exactly how many points somebody has for your certain rules that you've set up. You can start to understand important actions. This will give you some insights into, are people actually reading your emails? Are they clicking on your call to actions in your emails? Are they engaging in the ways in which you're driving them towards? You can then measure this contact engagement by creating certain score systems around these things. If you want, you can predetermine all of your different rules for how contacts can obtain points and create one general score for that contact engagement. If you want to break it up into little pieces so that you can understand individualized actions and things that people are doing in order to build their scoring system with you, you can do that as well. Lead scoring is also effective in identifying contacts' interests. It will help you to determine, based on segmentation and the segments that you're building, what specific contacts are actually interested in. If they click on your leashes links more often than they click on your collars links, it might be a good idea to send them maybe a discount code or more information on your leashes or collars. This will then help you determine what those conversions are and how soon they're going to be happening. Once you start to set thresholds for your points within your lead scoring system, you're going to be able to know at exactly what point somebody's going to make a conversion based on the score that they have. You can then take the scoring systems that you've put into place and create tailored campaigns around the things that make the most sense for your contacts at that time. Let's say Tabitha got a score of 75. You can then send her a campaign or enter her into an automation based on her reaching that threshold and you now interacting with her in that specific way. We talk a lot about right message to the right person at the right time, and lead scoring is going to drive you to that perfectly segmented message. Now that we're back in the platform, what we want to do is check out lead scoring and build out a system that makes sense as it pertains to Boone's Bandanas. So we are going to go into our contact section, as that's where scoring lives. And we'll go to the manage scoring section, which you'll see in the folders on your left-hand side. You can see that there's a series of rules that are already set up, three of which are active, one of which is in a draft. We are going to be editing the drafted one, Boone's Engagement Scoring, and we're going to simply press edit. If you wanted to create a score from scratch, you could simply click add a score and set up your score from that. Now that we have this already set up, we want to start implementing rules that are going to make sense for the scores that we're building. So we're going to click on add a new rule. We'll make a note of this blue box after we add our rules so that we can talk to the different opportunities you have here. The first condition that we want to set up is that somebody joins the list dog community. Since this is based around community tags, we want you to be able to get points for actually joining the list. That's what's most important to us here. Our dog community operates a little bit differently than our customers, our animal shelters, and just our general newsletter contacts. Our dog community is based really on a lot of participation by just making posts and letting people know of different things that are going on. So it's really important that somebody continues to build their points based on interacting and staying active within the dog community. So let's go ahead and create some more rules that will really help this person gain traction in this engagement tagging scenario. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a tag. Tag exists, and it's going to be community dog parks, and we're going to press save. And we're going to do the same thing for all of our other community tags. We'll type tag here so that we can easily filter to that folder. And then we will press save. Now we can change the points in just a minute, but let's add all of our conditions. Recipes. So them joining the list is the most important. So we want to go ahead and update the points to 15. We want to make sure that they're getting a bulk good start on their point system just simply for joining. While this takes a little bit of a backseat, these tags are going to really allow you to identify what people are interested in within the community, but it's not necessarily the key identifier. So every time somebody gets one of these tags, we are going to add 7 points. There's other things that we can do here as far as adding rules. We're not necessarily going to add any more here, but I want to highlight all the different possibilities that you have. We often talk about how many places the segment builder lives in within the platform, and this is one of those places. You can always utilize any of these different folders. So maybe it's really important for you to know that they have visited the www.boonsbandanas.com/community page. You can say ever, you can say 2 to 5, 6 to 15, or 16 plus times. Maybe as this number grows, you add more points. Here we can say it's really important for them to visit the website, but that's just how they start showing interest. And then what we can do is continue to build on that. Note that this will only work if the contact is cookied. So you wanna make sure that you're continuously cooking your contacts through call to actions and form submissions. As I said, you can continue to build rules that make sense. So whether it be visiting your website, making some kind of purchase through your e-commerce integration, you can also go to different option categories such as deal details or conversions. Actions is a very common one. Opening an email, clicking on a link in an email. Maybe one that's really important is going to be going to the Shopify store. Again, we don't necessarily need to add points just for the sake of adding them, but do things that really make sense to your process. Once you're done adding your point system, you can go ahead and press save, and then you can choose to make it active. One important thing that we said we wanted to touch on here is that rules only run once for each contact. So as long as I only get this tag once, I'm gonna get 7 points. If I were to lose this tag and get it again, I would not get the 7 points again. The same goes for visiting the webpage. This is going to be one that you'll see happen more commonly. What I would recommend here is actually setting up an automation with a start trigger of score changes, and then making sure that you're adding the point. You can also use a start trigger of web pages visited, tag is added, or subscribes to a list in order to ensure that every time an action is completed within an engagement score that you've set up, you're consistently adding those points for that person to get the points that they deserve based on the actions you've created.